guys, it's Queendija, and in today's video, I will be reacting to the final Magical Girl Lyrical Nanoha movie. It's weird to say that we are here, because, I mean, damn. Still cannot believe this was in two parts, because I'm like, oh yeah, like, one's like an hour, and you know, oh my god, like, I was like, this is short, but... I wonder how this is going to end. Of course, we're going to get a happy ending. I need that happy ending, of course. I feel like we're going to see Nanoha as, like... Do I feel like Nanoha is going to be, like, Madoka and get, like, a goddess-type power? A little bit of yes and a little bit of no. But, you know, we have to just see. That's all. But, of course, we're going to see some bullshit powers. Because, of course, magical girl-esque in a nutshell. But other than that, it's gonna get started with part one of the first half of the movie in 3, 2, 1, go. And just like with the last three, you will have the parts in the description below. I just have to do it before I go to bed tonight. I wonder if it's just gonna like start right with the last movie I did, which would make the most sense, but who knows. I should have got more water. I have candy. Yeah, they're what I was like previously. Kitty. If you only knew, baby. The queen. That's all. Fate is a queen. Oh, yeah, we are, like, whoa, that's smart. Oh, my God, that's a Prettycure move, because Prettycure did that. And I wish every season of Prettycure would do that-ish. Skip the opening credits and everything and just go right into the action. Oh, dang. See, that couldn't have been me. Once something would have started happening, not when something is coming out above the water. No. Once something starts forming, I've been like, okay, it's time to go. Aw, snap. You gotta love Nanoha. She's like, yes, let me apologize first. What's the bad news? Okay. So, what's the bad? And if we don't finish it in 3 minutes, just the person that knows the truth. Now, see, I thought her sister would have been like, nope, don't shoot my sister. And blah. Nope. Oh God, please make it. Oh my God, fucking Yuri isn't gonna give up. Oh. That's right, push it back. Push it back so Nanoha can get the hit! And watch, she gonna do something to just dodge all that. Is she okay now? Is she normal? She hurt, but is she on our side now? Oh, okay. I don't like the way this is going. Hey, you know what? Oh! really thought Yuri would have been protected in that bubble, but they said no. I shouldn't be laughing. I'm sorry. I know it's supposed to be a serious moment, but like, oh, that just happened too fast. But at the same time, I felt like there's no way they can save Iris. Like, she's too far gone. Like, there's no way. I felt like Iris is just gonna die by the end of this, so. Did I turn? I don't know. Did I? Yeah, I did. Okay. Yeah, but still, like, the situation of Iris and Yuri, like, it's still a lot of unanswered questions. And we're only, what, good 10 minutes into the film? Oh. Hold up. Wait. How can there be data inside something that small? I'm sorry. No, I mean, it ain't gonna be a lot, though. Mm-mm. You still got the whole rest of the film to stop her. See, that's fate waifu in the nutshell. Like, yes, are you okay? How was your exam? Oh my god. But like, my wife is okay. Oh god, she's gonna get distracted by food. Mm-hmm. But Oh, at least she taking a responsibility for it, because, yeah. But you didn't know. You didn't know what she was going to do. Exactly. So, still, yes, even though you have some part of this, still, you didn't know. It'll be okay. The baby's gonna go on a date, even though everything that's happening right now. We need to have happy moments. Yep, and have a good summer. That's it is. I mean, look how happy she is in this video. I'm positive she's thinking in a way, but of course you know that despair inducing moment is coming where she does lose everything, and because of that, that is why she went down the path that she currently is now. See, this part right here just reminded me of one of the horror movies you watch, where it's like, oh, hey, this is the last thing they're going to see before insert character here dies. Like, oh, I'm sorry. Like, you know, one of them found footage type films. Oh, Yuri. Welcome. Okay. Mm-hmm. It has a vast knowledge. Ah, of course. Yeah, can't revive the dead. That's, you know, pretty much with everything in a nutshell. Can't do that. That's not good. Excuse me. I think we, you know, probably not advised to do that, but, you know, hey. I have a bad feeling about this. Oh, nice. But still more advanced. Oh. Yeah, there's that thing that she made. Oh, you shouldn't have said that! You should not have said that! Can we just talk about the fact that she looks like Nanali from Code Geass? Like, oh my god. Like, I can't. Except, you know, she's more blonder than Nanali. Nanali is more like a dirty blonde. And just adorable as fuck. Because it's Nanali! And I love her! That's a bad idea. Like Yuri, say no. That's peer pressure. Say no to drugs. Say no. Oh, yeah, it is. It is a selfish request. Well, okay, hold on. We know she probably wasn't able to stay long because she eventually went back to sleep. They girlfriends too. And then they broke up. And then she killed a girlfriend. Woo! All right. Oh, and them new possibilities. Oh, ho, ho! Yep, this would be the last time when they were really, truly happy. But, because there's always a but. That's That's good. Mm-hmm. It's always about money. Money makes the world go round. Money is everything that we need for everything. That's it. She had to. I mean, you only have that one paper, and that one paper only is going to give you a certain amount. Oh! Hey, yo, hold up. Whoa, 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 whoa! Hold up! Oh! Oh! What?! Like, okay, hold up. What if something took over Yuri and then killed everyone else? And that could be the reason why it is so angry at her. But it says no. Who? Because there's so many what ifs right now. Because as she said, her powers can destroy things. So something else had happened that made Yuri end up destroying and killing everyone. Possibly so. Mm-hmm. And that's how she became reborn. Oh, shoot, excuse me. Mm-hmm. And she's been there ever since. And see, she's saying it, if it really. Come on now. So, of course, she's been questioning it for the last few years. Centuries, even. And see, she did. Oh, dang! She did that like it was nothing! Mm-mm. They might have to kill Yuri. Oh my god, no. Not the precious other Nonnally. Oh my god. Don't make me cry over her! I don't want that. Come on now. I mean, yes, it's the final movie and I'm supposed to cry almost about everything, but no. How many minutes we got left? I know we're like 36 minutes. We got 19 minutes left. Oh my god. And now they're separating. I mean, hey, yeah, for now, but one of y'all could just be like, you know what? Right? I mean, because you're already hurting right now and you don't want to make it worse. But look at them. They all ready for everything. Oh, she's ready. Too bad she probably ain't got no name, right? I'm sorry. Her voice pretty too, oh my god. Right? Because all you have to do is just surrender. If you surrender peacefully, you'll be okay. We really have... Wait, hold on. Wait, time out. We can't have a conversation. We supposed to be fighting. Come on now. Oh, that was so good. How many minutes do I have left? Because I kind of have to pee. 12. Seriously, once again, not that Mizuki was having fun with this role. I mean, because, of course... Levy is, like, completely different from Faith. It's cute. Like, oh my god. Okay, I thought you stopped only because you hard-headed, but that's okay. True, yes, you're right. Aw, it's so cute. Aw. I know, right? Like, do you know who you're talking to? It's freaking Fate. I wonder, are we literally about to have these three go against Yuri? Because, I mean, Yuri is a little OP and such. And now that, you know, once again, Idis is taking over her. So that means she might be really OP. The talent you have to just, like, you know, still drive and shoot at the same time, bruh. Mm-mm. Such a badass. Oh, this is gonna be good. Probably sad too, but good. And the thing is, Yuri doesn't relate, like, what she is doing. So, like, oh, when she wakes up again. But this is only to wake you up and to snap you out of it. I get that, because she doesn't want to be lonely. You'll be alone. They were the cats. I mean, can we at least see them? Oh, I got 3 minutes left. Okay. Nah. Yeah, that is them. I think everything's going good. That's what's his face. Uh-huh. What the fuck? Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Well, that was an interesting way to pause and cliffhanger myself, DJ. Oh my god. Okay. This is good. This is good. Good. That's all I gotta say. Go ahead and pause the video, and I'll see you guys in 1 second for the second half of this movie. I will be right back. Okay. Second half of the movie in 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. Jesus, that was quick. Oh! You happy about that? You don't blame just Yuri. You also blame yourself secretly. Girl, they're destroying the whole dang place. Oh my god! Yeah, of course. Him. Yes! 1-7! It's usually a guy. Oh my god. So she literally got double crossed by him just as much as Iris was doing that to Katie. That is nuts. In the end, he's the true villain of this. Played all of you like pawns. But then, okay, hold on. Oh. Is this supposed to be Iris or, like, Yuri? Iris. He was your father, basically. But, because there's a but. It ain't a funny in the end. He did get the last laugh. I mean, because come on, he the ultimate villain of this one now. I mean, Jesus. He went and had everyone kill everybody. That's so messed up. Oh. Oh, dang! And then she's gonna, oh, she's gonna, yep, she's coming back and she's gonna see that. And then that's gonna, she's gonna think that's the reason why everything happened the way it did. Oh my God. Yes, but not in the way that you're doing it. This is a little too much. We don't do that. Mm-mm. There's a line. And you have crossed that line. That's what he wanted, though. This To kill her too. Oh, of course. Thanks for nothing. The fact that he also was like, okay, the only way to end this is to literally just off everyone and to have this grand plan of, oh, hey, making it look like Yuri offed me and then having my child come in, witness this and see that and then, oh, dang. Like, more advanced, of course. Ew, that looks so nasty. Get out of there before she hurts you! The fact that he would sacrifice his own child that he labeled as his child, both of them, because of the fact is, yes, he thought of both of them as his own children. That's so messed up. Having your children do your dirty work is the most, like, dishonorable thing that you can do as a parent. Oh, she might have to. Oh, God. She still cares for you. Please kill this man. I need him to go. It's time. Don't kill Yuri, because Yuri precious baby girl, but kill him. He an ass for making both of his so-called quote-unquote daughters to hurt each other and everyone else. He got blood on his hands! Exactly. And don't you want to be with Yuri? Okay, good. The fact that he was deceived. Oh, dang. I mean, not the face at the same time, too, but like, ooh! Not know how you have to do it, I know, but still! You know you wrong. You know you wrong. So, There you go. Now please kill this man. It's time. Even though we 25 minutes, like, technically an hour and so many minutes left in this movie, and we only have 30 more minutes left, it's time for him to go. Exit. Stage left. Stage right. Center stage. Get it and go! Honestly, seriously, by the end of this, he getting his ass beat by a 13-year-old! Sorry! Now remember, we're just trying to save Yuri. We're not trying to kill her. The only way. God, why is it... Oh, yep, it's always the weakness. Little kids in anime and animals in anime. The weakness. Oh my God. Oh, that just hurt. Oh God, he's coming! No fate! Now let him die. Don't come back. There you go. There you go. There we go. Huh? Okay. We got less than what? We got 24 minutes left. Technically, really not looking at this. Like, what, 20, at least like 23, 22. How the heck is this movie gonna end? It was, but at least y'all did it. Oh, dang. What the fuck is that? Oh! God damn it. This mofo right here. You already lost! Need to plans if he wants to destroy the whole fucking world. Oh God, he had all this. Oh, that's BS. Exactly. There's not enough time! She's already up there! She got it. You better not die! I'm guessing that's a no. Oh, damn. Nanoha did not just die. No! My baby lost an arm. I love how she literally is like, yes, let me talk about everybody else and let me just do fate. There we go! There we go! Oh, honey. So we just gonna leave him. I'm sorry. Yo. Sorry, that's funny. That is so funny. Oh shit, I can't. Oh god. My stomach hurt. Mm-hmm. Girl, no, no, Fate don't care about that. Mm-hmm. That's the wife in her. Right? I mean, I thought y'all would have been a little more comfortable returning home, not just like, Look at them. Look at the girlfriends. My baby! That's good.
Look how older they look!
That was good. I mean, you know what? For a good four-part series of a movie with a beginning, middle, and end, all the way in every single movie, each one was good. Really, really good. I mean, damn. Like, it was really interesting to go back and to revisit it because, like I said, it's been a long time since I got into this series and watched it. And to see everything from the beginning to the end with all four of these movies was really good. I do love the fact that with this movie, as I said in the beginning, that they really was like, okay, instead of us getting something new, we're continuing it right with where it left off. Yes, giving a little recap, but to instantly at the same time getting back into the action. That final little moment where Nanoha had the upper hand, but still Philip was like, oh, no, and then just had the bomb inside of his daughter or one of his many daughters and shit. And just to see her, like, even though it looked like she had her arm still, but the way it looked, how it had her arm darkened, I'm like, damn, she just lost an arm too. Like, no, like, oh my God. And then her saying that she doesn't like herself, like, that hurt, because I mean, in a way, we've all felt that about ourselves, where we secretly just don't like ourselves, but we're just here in the moment and we're just trying to deal with everything day by day and the situations that we have to deal with on a daily basis and such. It is hard, trust me. Like, once again, you made me cry. You made me fucking cry. That's all that matters, ain't it? You're making me cry. Because, like, once again, I don't like crying. I like crying. I just think I look ugly when I cry when I'm watching anime or stuff. Because when I'm watching an anime and it makes me cry, I feel like I look so ugly. And I'm like, I feel like people are like, oh my God, yes, I'm crying with Queen. But at the same time, like, this girl is really crying on screen. Oh my God. But I really loved this. This was really good. And I am sad that it is over, honestly. But now we get to continue on to, or really not continue, start other things that a lot of other people have been waiting for. But yeah, this was a really interesting series. Loved it even more as I did when I was like, God, I don't even remember how old I was when I watched this. I know I was in middle school. But this was good. Oh God, that part. No, why would you shout that again? Oh my God. Damn. But like, ooh. Something just told me, like, yes, the dad was not going to survive. Like, as much as, like, we wanted that happy ending where he could really, truly be healthy, living, and thriving, something just told me he was not going to be able to survive in the end because, excuse me, you have to kind of look at the truth of it, where it's like, yes, in the environment that he truly was, he's gone from a healthy one to a non-healthy one, back into a healthy one. His body was not going to preserve all of that, so it was only a little matter of time before he was going to pass away, but at least he passed away comfortably and not in any more pain, and that he was with his family up until the end. That's all that matters. And then, yes, the fact that both of her girlfriends, mainly Fate, her wife, and then her second girlfriend, came in to save her. Like, oh. That was cute. Like, oh. That was so good. So, so good. 10 out of 10. Would recommend. I really have nothing else to say. Like, that's all. Oh, it's a pretty picture. God, imagine how many hours that took to draw that thing. Like, the time. That time. Like, oh God. But now you're probably wondering, okay, now that we are finally done with the Magical Girl Lyrical Nanoha series, what am I watching next? Honestly, I have to go back and look for Patreon stuff because it has been a little hot minute because busy with work and everything else. But what I think I'm going to do, I'm going to pause. So I'm going to stop here mid-sentence and then we'll continue on in a couple of minutes. So I'll see you guys in one sec. Okay, so as I was saying, the plan is, like I said, is to continue whatever the next series is after this. But I think this is what I'm going to do because I'm going to go ahead and say this now. So this is strictly for patrons. And patrons only, so everybody else, I hope you did enjoy the video. Thank you for watching. So for patrons, for now, and I probably will also say this in the comment of the post when this comes out later on tomorrow, even though it's like 10:55 right now, it's almost 11 o'clock, Friday and such. I am going to take a little hiatus on movies. I want to finish the last 4 episodes that I have of Jobless Reincarnation, and then kind of really go back to continuing just watching, like, regular 12 to maybe 24 episode anime series, because movies do take a really, honestly, God's truth, a long time to really edit and such, and it's super, like, it's not super hard, it sometimes gets difficult at times to, you know, want to be able to watch a movie, and then when I'm coming home from work, I am, like, uber tired, and I'm like, bruh, how am I gonna get like this? Because with these 4 movies, it, like, literally took forever, because remember, the first 2 movies are, like, 2 hours long, and I had to get that in, like, what, 3 parts, and then these 2 were only, like, an hour and 50-something minutes long, under 2 hours, and I was able to get that done, too. And then you have to imagine the edit. Usually the edits for these movies, or just movies in general, because I have to do them in parts, takes at least about maybe a good 2 to 3, 4 hours long. And depending on what time I start the edit, like I said, it is almost 11 o'clock now. For me, I'm guessing this edit isn't going to be done till about like maybe 3-4 o'clock in the morning, at least a couple of hours before I have to go to work tomorrow and such. So I, as much as I didn't want to do this, but I think it's just a little bit right for me as of right now. I think we're going to just take a pause on movies. I will say, yes, you guys can still eventually take or give me requests on movies. I don't know when I will resume doing or taking movies as Patreon requests. I just think rather right now, I kind of want to wait a little bit, like at least a good couple of months, to just like go back into the groove of watching at least 2 to 4 episodes of something. Because like, how I also still want to watch JoJo. I've only watched like 2 episodes of JoJo, and my goal was today on Friday on the fucking 16th. Was to watch at least, like, what, 6 episodes today, so that tomorrow, or at least, like, Sunday night, that between everything else that I had to do, I would have only had to do more, like, what, 4 more episodes before I would have been caught up with everybody else. But because of the fact is, when I went to the movies on Thursday night with my mom, we didn't get home till about at least almost 8 going on 9, and I had to immediately watch Danmachi, and I had situations with that. And I was gonna watch this movie literally right after, but I fell asleep while the edit was like at least like 17 minutes left, which was the reason why, like, if most of you don't know, because like it was crazy last night, or really Friday morning when I woke up, it was like 1:30 going on, I think, no, what, like at least 2:15 going on 2:30, and I'm like, oh shoot, like I need to go back to sleep, I need to upload this, like it was very chaotic this morning, having to wake up and be like, what the heck just happened to me, like when did I go to sleep? And I really wanted to watch the movie today so that like I could have had it edited while I was at work, and then I could have came home, uploaded it, got it done, at least done a couple of episodes of JoJo, and then did the rest tomorrow and such. But yeah, like I said, as much as I love doing reactions to movies, we are going to just take a little pause. So to the people who have been waiting for the longest on some of the shows, I need you guys to at least sometime tomorrow or in the next couple of weeks, at least the next 2 weeks, by the time when I do finish Jobless Reincarnation, anything that you've already had requested before I had started watching both the Nanoha series and Jobless, give me your stuff so that I can go ahead and like immediately pick the next 2 shows that I'm going to watch next after Jobless, and then so we can go ahead and start fresh and continue on from that, and then after that, we'll just go from there. Just, you know, hey, like I said, it's good. Once again, it still is hectic. We about to get a little bit closer into fall anime, so you already know it's about to be even more hectic, especially with all the new shows that are coming in, and especially the shows that I am very much anticipating, because looking at my schedule right now, I already know that it's going to be even more hectic than it was during summer. Because of course it's fall and all the good ish always wants to come out into fall. That is like To Your Eternity season 2, Bleach, The Thousand Year Blood War, which is one of my most anticipated shows. The second half of Spy Family, Pop Team Epic season 2, and several freaking others. So yeah, it is going to be hard for the next couple of weeks, leading up into my birthday. But I'm going to try my best to get everything out as best as I can. If I do not get it out Saturdays, at least like Saturday morning, maybe by the, like, usually I have it out for y'all, but like what, 10 o'clock? If maybe one of two things are out by 10 o'clock, just know that maybe if I'm not home, I am at work, and when I come home, I'll immediately get it out for you guys. And if there's any time where I have to postpone, of course you will, I cannot speak. You will know firsthand, because I literally will tell you guys immediately, or probably the night before. That's when I'll post it, so that you guys can see it early in the morning when you guys get up. But thank you guys so much for enjoying this series with me. Like I said, I really enjoyed going back into this and re-envisioning or re-involving myself into this show, because it brought back a lot of memories that I've had. Like I said, it's been a hell of a long time since I've seen this series, and to have so many things like come back, it just feels so freaking weird. But it is so, once again, weird to say this, that we're done with it, and sad at the same time. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards all four movie series of Magical Girl Lyrical Nanoha. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And, of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday for Patreons, and next Wednesday for everybody else for the next two episodes of Java's Reincarnation, and, well, really for the last couple episodes, because hopefully in the next 2 weeks we do get that done. And then after that, whatever in the world we're going to be watching next, because honestly, I still have no clue. So once the Patreons tell me what in the world I'm watching next, that is when I know, and then eventually you will know that following Monday. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye!